Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Today we have with us Hamraj Singh, who is a political analyst and previously worked with Member of Parliament as a research associate. And the budget session in the Parliament is going on, and we're here to discuss the citizens' participation and how citizens can participate in the parliamentary discussion and debate. And a very important aspect of it to begin with is the questionnaire. You know, when we talk about Parliament, we mostly think about bills or the opposition parties, debating and discussing and arguing, but it is much more than that. So if you could begin by telling us with what is this questionnaire and why is it important?
See, the first R in Lok Sabha is questionnaire and the second R in Rajya Sabha is questionnaire. It itself says how important it is. Mm-hmm. In a questionnaire, an MP gets an opportunity to ask various ministries question pertaining to his constituency and also to the nation as a whole. This is a time where in Rajya Sabha one can ask 50, not one, but overall people can ask, the MPs can ask 15 questions, and at the same time in Lok Sabha one can, the complete lot can ask 20 questions. So there are a lot of questions an MP can raise throughout a session.
And it's written and oral both.
So there are 15 questions in Rajya Sabha, which is in oral form, and 160 questions, which is in written form. And similarly, there are 20 questions in Lok Sabha, which is in oral form, and 230 questions, which is in written form. And the questions can be to various ministries. The dates are allotted for the same. And the questions are largely focused on different schemes, policies, promises which were made by the ministries, and therefore it creates a lot of accountability in the parliament. The MPs should focus more on making it more productive, more creative, because this is a time where we can actually ensure that the promises made by the minister, the government, is getting fulfilled or not getting fulfilled, or where things are lacking. So those clarities comes in through questionnaire. So it's very important that we focus, these MPs focus a lot on.
Right. And we also get a lot of, through these questions, a lot of information we get as, you know, when we are seeing the session. This is a medium that we can get.
The information which comes out is the most authentic information, because these are coming on the floor of the house. And these are coming from ministries. So these are most authentic informations and has its credibility. It's important that the questions are properly framed, because a properly framed question will generate more information, and an improperly framed question will not be able to generate that much of information. So the MPs can bring in a lot of data. I'll just give you an example. When I used to work with an MP in the parliament, we asked the question about SIT formed by this government on anti-Sikh riots and about its progress. So we got to know how they have witnessed met with 1,000 witnesses, how they have reopened 60 cases, working on them. So these information came in public domain for the first time through questionnaire. So these questionnaire is very important, and I think unfortunately we are not giving that much focus or emphasis on this. I'll also share another example. So nowadays we have this whole debate on raffle deals and on the whether it is a scam or a proper deal, or why it was reduced from 100 plus aircrafts to 36 aircrafts. So I'll give you an instance from Lok Sabha, November 2016, I think. A Lok Sabha MP raised this question on the budget at which these aircrafts were brought. And Defence Ministry has categorically said that it is somewhat 650 crores. The same Defence Ministry is saying that we cannot bring out and open that what was the deal, what was the amount per aircraft signed. But this information is already in public domain that it was 650 crores. So that's how powerful this questionnaire is.
And how can we as citizens get our question to the parliament through this?
See, every member of parliament represents a lot of citizens, approximately 20 lakh per member of parliament. And Rajya Sabha MPs also are indirectly representing a lot of people. So there can be two ways where normal public or media organizations or even civil societies can participate. One way is when that question is worked, question is written. So say I want to understand or I want to know that the AIIMS which was supposed to be constructed in my city, when it will be constructed, what stage we have reached. So I'll send a letter to my MP requesting him to ask this question. Maybe I'll tweet my MP and ask him to raise this question.
That also works.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, see, that doesn't work, but we have to ensure that that will work in future. Okay. So we'll have to force our MP that, sir or ma'am, you have to raise this question because this question concerns us and you are our representation in parliament. So we can tweet, we can create, we can write articles and... Or we can just directly meet our MP and say... bring it to their notice. And once it is brought to their notice, it is important that we follow up that those questions are coming up in Parliament. Mm-hmm. Similarly, media organizations and civil societies should also discuss things with Member of Parliament, should also get an understanding of what are the issues they are raising. Mm-hmm. And if there are some informations which are not in public domain, say... what is the allotment done for smart cities? So how do we know that? We can approach an MP to use this question in the parliament, and through that we can understand. The most interesting part is that budget session is on, and budget session is all about dividing the funds among for various schemes and for various ministries. After 6 months, when we have to know that if, say, 1,000 crore was allotted for some project, so what is the progress or how much fund is used? That is where this question comes in. That is where the role of these questions comes in. And a media organization or civil society can push an MP, can ask an MP, can request an MP to use these questions. And it is also important that once these questions are asked, and this brings a lot of information in public domain. So the civil societies, the media people should use this information in their articles. If we don't use them, unfortunately, only showing media debates in a form of war, fight, sitting in a TV studio doesn't solve the purpose of the journalism as a whole and the media as a whole.
Creating awareness on what's actually happening
exactly.
The country and the policies and the effects of the policies that are going to take place.
Exactly. And using questionnaire is the best way to do that is what I believe.
Are there any shortcomings to this questionnaire, or is there any scope of improvement in making it better?
See, questionnaire is a wonderful initiative in itself, which was designed and planned by our parliamentary forefathers. But the only problem is that we don't discuss it for the complete 1 hour which is allotted for it. Less than 50% is the productivity of this hour in Lok Sabha, and similar is the situation in Rajya Sabha. So you can...
Throughout
the years. I mean, this is the general trend which I'm saying for past 1 or 2 years. Mm-hmm. And out of 15 questions, say 5 or 6 get answered. So this is really problematic.
But why does this happen?
This happens because of disruption in parliament. The opposition wanted to raise some questions, some issues, and the government is not ready to take those issues. So that debate starts, that ruckus start in the parliament, and this 1 hour get derailed.
Because people are not really... included with the what goes on in the parliament, and I don't think that people are anymore watching also what happens in Lok Sabha. So how do you think we can improve this, get this by that people should be more aware and more conscious and encouraged to know about what is happening in parliament, because it's going to directly affect their lives?
I think the shows like this will be very helpful. Debating and discussing how parliament functions is very important. It's important that government takes up this initiative and discuss parliamentary procedures in different universities, colleges, and at different platforms. Similarly, civil societies, NGOs, and media should come up with such debates, organize mini parliaments, and participate there. So these things will bring in more participation. And once the more participation comes in, once people are more aware about the parliament and its functioning, this will automatically make our MPs more accountable. And this will automatically ensure that the parliament functions properly, and the productivity of the parliament will automatically increase. Last year, the number of days parliament functioned was very, very low. I mean, maybe the lowest from the beginning of the parliament has started in the country, and it is very unfortunate. And since this is not a matter of debate for we general people, the government is fine with it. So we are largely focused on TV debates and those things, but we have to ensure that these things which are actually affecting an individual life, which is actually affecting the growth of the nation, is actually addressed properly. And somewhere we have reduced from 100 days or 100 days plus of parliament to somewhat 50, 60, 70 days of parliament. And this trend has to change, is what I believe.
Another thing I want to know is the Prime Minister through this approachable?
The questionnaire.
Yeah, and through the questionnaire. Can we pose questions to the Prime Minister also?
Definitely. I mean, there are days when the question can be posed to Prime Minister. But unfortunately, there is a trend in our country that the Prime Minister generally don't answer that question. I'll compare this with the Western democracies, maybe Britain. Britain, you'll see that the Prime Minister answers each and every question posed to her or him by the Member of Parliament. The same should happen in the country also. That is the rules. It should happen in our country. But unfortunately, what we see that the Prime Minister office doesn't answer. I mean, the Prime Minister doesn't answer question. Maybe a junior minister on his behalf is answering the question, but the Prime Minister of the nation is not answering those questions. And this trend has to change. So I think our Prime Minister, who is so vocal on various platforms, should take this opportunity and answers the grievances of different member of parliaments and actually answering the grievances of common public at large.
More information and more details of the policies should be given to the public. But unfortunately, what we see in media is not what's happening in the parliament, but more about how, you know, the ridiculous topics that we do see in mainstream media. So through the involvement of citizens, media and the government, how do you think we can improve the structure of parliament? As you said that the productivity is also reducing. And you have mentioned a few points before, but also I would like you to re-emphasize on points on how we citizens can get more included in parliament, in the parliamentary session discussion and debate, and how can the media and the government also be part of that?
See, I think the first step for every citizen is to at least start giving some time to watch Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha TV. You can watch the actual debates. Maybe use the, just watch the topics you like, but you can watch the actual debates. The media fraternity, the civil societies should improve the participation of people by creating awareness among them. So, other important things which civil societies, NGOs and media focuses on, they should specially give some time to discuss and debate how the parliament functions every day. And I think that would be a best way to generate more participation among people. And for common public, I think start interacting with your member of parliaments. We have this phobia that member of parliaments are hard to meet, or they are unapproachable,
which they should not be.
So it should start happening from both the sides. The MPs needs to get more approachable. Thanks to Twitter, somewhat that's happening.
So do you think that because of this ignorance from the citizen side and also the media side, that it kind of gives leniency to the MPs it lessens the accountability because we are not really caring about what's happening?
Oh, definitely. I mean, I believe around half of the MPs don't file the number of questions they are allowed to file. Mm. It's only less than half of the MPs who use the complete strength which is given to them. Mm. So why those MPs don't ask questions? It's strange. We should also check the attendance of these MPs in the parliament. Of are they attending parliament regularly? How many number of debates are they participating? Are they listening? What private member bills have they raised in the parliament? And I would recommend two things for the people to actually go through other than Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha TV. The one is the Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha website. It has all the information one needs to look at. The other is the PRS Legislative Services. They are doing tremendous work to improve the quality of the parliament. And one can track their MP's performance, parliamentary performance in the PRS website. It's a wonderful platform to understand any bills with a one-pager document.
This hopefully spreads more awareness and encourages, provokes people to get more inclusive with the parliament debates and further will also discuss about these issues. Thank you for joining us.